Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to part 9 of What If Tsunade Was Naruto's Mother. But before we start, go ahead and check out Naruto, the God of Shinobi. I posted a new episode on my second channel. And what if Naruto was trained to be a mercenary? It's gonna be out after this what if. So make sure to stay in tune and turn on that bell notification so you can see exactly when I post. Remember to get this one to 100 likes as usual. Share to all of your friends on your social media platform, and if you haven't yet, what are you waiting for, new visitors? Go ahead and click that red subscribe button and join the Anime King family. Turn on bell notifications to stay posted, and also go ahead and check out my second channel, Anime King 2. The link will be at the top of the description. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. Start the intro. You can change. To do a bit of a recap, we mainly focus on Naruto with the cloud ninjas as they had captured him. Killer B came there and captured Naruto. Naruto could break free, but he didn't want anyone to find out about his special abilities like his Mokiton. So he decided to just stay there as they questioned him a lot. Naruto told them that his mother, his sister, and him and his little pig Tauntaun are going around because his mother is a healer and she's from a village that is now turned into a total hot spring. After a little bit of confusing, they decide to believe Naruto. So yeah, you guys can go ahead and check it out when Naruto face off against Yujito in her Bijuu form. So yeah, let's start this new episode. And why were you training in the forest by yourself? Samui asks Naruto. I like to train by myself sometimes, Naruto said. Okay, I'm a bit convinced, said Yujito. But why were you watching us? Why didn't you just look and then leave? Well, I was curious in Kenjutsu because the only thing I really know about it is what I read in book. And I really want to see what your sensei was teaching you, Naruto said. Killer B then looked at Naruto. Well, if you want to roll with the big dogs, then let's bow wow and see what you got, said Killer B. Sensei, you can't be serious, Karu said, as she was the only one who still did not trust Naruto. But the rest of her teammates were surprised. What? What did he just say? Asked Naruto, not understanding Killer B bad rapping. Why not? Killer B said. The kid got style and pizzazz. And by the way, he totally pwned all of you, Killer B said, while he did his rap dance, as all of them were annoyed to remember that Naruto defeated them all. Can someone please tell me what you guys are talking about, because I can barely understand what he's saying, Naruto said, a little annoyed because of the man bad rapping. Sensei just said if you are interested in Kenjutsu, then you can learn with us and train with us if you want. That is if you can keep up. Yujito answered. She still couldn't believe that her sensei was allowing a boy they just met and didn't know well to train with them, even though he had a very convincing story. Sensei, you can't be serious. We cannot let him just join us. What if this all is a plot to just kill us? What if he's lying? We do not know this kid, Karu said angrily. Hey, don't call me just a kid. I'm not that much younger than you. Besides, I was able to defeat all of you. Also, I wasn't the one who was left hanging up in a tree like a sack of potatoes, said Naruto. As he smirked when he saw Karu's face turn red from anger and humiliation, when she remembered how Naruto defeated her. That still doesn't say that you're not lying or trying to trick us, Karu said. Before Naruto could respond, Killer B interrupted him. The squirt is not lying. He's not the type. I can see it in his eyes, you know. Huh? Said Naruto. as he wasn't sure if Killer B just complimented him or not. "He says that he believes you and he has trust in you," said Amoy, as Naruto nodded, "Thanks." "Alright then, let's get this party started and get down to the beatdown." "Does he always talk like that?" Naruto asked Amoy. "Pretty much," Amoy said. For the next 2 weeks, Naruto has been training with the Kyuumo Genins under Killer B, where he will leave his house early in the morning and go out to the forest telling his mother and Shizune that he's going off to train by himself. Neither Tsunade or Shizune knew that Naruto was training with a secret group of shinobis from the cloud. Because Naruto knew if his mother or Shizune knew about this, they will freak out and forbid him to see them ever again, and he won't be able to train. During those 2 weeks, Naruto got to know them a lot better. He find Killer B as a funny person, but even though, he didn't understand him most time because of that bad rapping. Naruto also learned that both B and Yujito were Jinjurikis. He learned this because Killer B made no secret that he had the 8 tails inside of him. And Naruto figured out that Yujito was one, since it explained that weird chakra that she used when the both of them were fighting. After Naruto asked them, they were surprised as they see that Naruto studied things and realized things quickly. They decided to tell him that she had the 2 tails inside of her. Naruto also became good friends with Amoy when they found out that they had a bit in common. Since, for example, the both of them were nearly always surrounded by girls, Naruto was always surrounded by his mother, Shizune, and Tonton. Yes, Tonton is a girl pig. While Amoy had Yujito, Samui, and Keru. Hence, it was nice for both of them to have some male companionship around their age. Despite their rocky start, Naruto and Yujito got along well and came up as rival. They would often spar against one another in taijutsu, where Naruto usually won, thanks to his advanced training with his mother, and in kenjutsu, Yujito always won since Naruto had much to learn about the sword. The only person on the team who Naruto hasn't got along with is Karu, as she still holds a grudge against Naruto for beating her and hanging her in the tree, and Killer B had to come and rescue her. Usually Naruto would caught her spying on him because she didn't trust him. She thought that he was an enemy shinobi trying to gain their trust, even though it has been 2 weeks. She still didn't trust him. Finally, there was Samui, who, despite the awkward situation that she and Naruto ended up in the forest, the both of them didn't have a problem with each other, as they came up to a truce, as she decided to tell him that she was willing to erase that incident if he's willing to do it as well. And Naruto did not have a problem with that, so he decided to go along with it like nothing ever happened. So after 2 weeks, Killer B decided that it's time for him to head back to his village because his brother must be looking for him and sending all sorts of shinobi to come and find him. While Killer B stood back as he watched Yujito and Naruto spar, as he couldn't help but be impressed at how quickly Naruto has grasped the basic of kenjutsu, although he was still a long way off of being on any of the other levels of kenjutsu. It was only 2 weeks and he has gotten really good, and Killer B was happy for that, as he knew that with more training, Naruto will become a perfect swordsman in the future. So after they stopped their sparring, Killer B told them that they will be heading back tomorrow, as Naruto had a sad look on his face. He hasn't met any real friends on this long road of his life. He is always moving to other villages and other villages, and he hasn't really come close to making friends like how these guys are his friends. Before Killer B decided to say anything else, he took out a small note and handed it to Naruto. "What? A piece of paper?" Naruto asked as he held it up, looking on it to see if there was anything specific about it. "That is not any ordinary paper," said Yujito, as she knew that Killer B would explain it in his wrapping and Naruto wouldn't understand. "That is a special paper from a tree that is fed and grown with chakra to make people find out their chakra affinities." "So, do you know about nature affinities?" Yujito asks. Naruto already knew about that, since the Mokitan is basically earth and water mixed together to create wood. But he decided to play dumb, since he didn't want Karu to get any more suspicious about him. So, he told them no, and they went on to explain everything about wind, earth, water, and fire, and lightning affinities. Naruto took the paper and channeled some of his chakra into it. The paper then split into three. As the first one turned into dirt, the second one became damp, and the third one was crumbled up, as all of them were surprised. This showed that Naruto had four nature affinities, one for earth, one for water, lightning, and wind. "Is this true?" Yujito thought. "For him to have four? No way," Karu thought. "Whoa," Amai thought. "Impossible," Samui thought, as Killer B nodded, as he was really impressed with this kid. He wanted to take Naruto back with them, but he knew that his brother will never allow this. Since Naruto is already this powerful, he would think that Naruto would be some kind of a spy. And if he ever heard that Naruto defeated Yujito in her tailpiece form, he would order Naruto to be killed. So, he didn't bring up the idea. Naruto was also shocked. He never expected this. He knew that he had earth and water, but he never expected lightning and wind. After everyone got over their shock, Killer B pulled out a scroll as he bit his thumb and ran through some hand signs. A green hilt katana then came out, as it had all sorts of style on the hilt. He then handed it to Naruto. "Whoa," Naruto said as he caught it. "What is this?" asked Naruto. "What do you think it is, stupid? It's not a butter knife. It's a katana for you. You're going to need one," Killer B said with a smirk. "For me?" Naruto said as he was so surprised. He never thought that he would get a sword. As Naruto ran over to him and gave him a hug, as he said thank you over and over again. As Killer B looked down at him, and know that Naruto will become powerful in the future. The next morning, Killer B and his student packed up their things as they were ready to leave. But before they could, Naruto arrived and say goodbye to his new friends. "See you around, Naruto, and take care of yourself. If you and your family are anywhere around Kumo, don't be shy. Pay us a visit," Amoy said, as Naruto shook his hand. "I suggest that you stay alive and get stronger, since I will become stronger the next time we meet," Yujito said. "Sure thing, Yujito, and you can expect a tougher fight the next time we battle," Naruto said with a smirk. Samui kept her face with no emotion as usual. She just offered Naruto her hand and said goodbye as Naruto shook it. Naruto then looked at Karu as she simply nodded goodbye, she said. As Naruto wasn't expecting that, he thought that she would have just leave without saying anything. Killer B said goodbye to Naruto and was ready to go into one of his long rhymes, but before he could, Yujito grabbed him by the collar and started to pull him. As Naruto watched his new friends went off, as Naruto said goodbye. Right here, we're going to have a 2-year time skip. After Naruto met B, he and Tsunade, they went to the Fire Daimyo, as the Fire Daimyo's son was very ill. And there was a whole thing with some low-level missing nin, where Naruto found out about his father, Minato. After hearing about Killer B and Yujito, he started to do research on the Bijuu, as he saw a perk of having a Bijuu is to heal very fast, and he realized how fast he healed and that he never has scars. So, after putting two and two together and researching about Konoha and the Biju attack and seeing a picture of Minato, Naruto quickly realized that Minato was his father. He talked to Jiraiya, Tsunade, and Shizune about this, which they confessed and told him. Naruto was angry at first that they didn't tell him, but after some convincing and talking him down, Naruto decided to let go of the anger. So 2 years have skipped. While Naruto was walking, he was going back to Konoha so he could become an official ninja. Tsunade was against it, but Jiraiya told her that it would be in his best interest for him to go there and learn more about his Mokuton ability from Yamato, and Konoha will eventually come to protect him. Well, if it was about his Mokuton ability or the Kyuubi. Eventually, after much arguing, Tsunade finally agreed that Naruto will go to Konoha, which made Naruto happy because he wanted to go back to the place that he was born and that was founded by his ancestors. Tsunade was currently dealing with a disease that spread in her country. She told Naruto once it was over, she would meet him at Konoha. Naruto has gotten very tall for his age. He was about 5'2". He wore a black sleeveless shirt with a vest over it, and he wore black long pants and black fingerless gloves with black boots. He also had his katana strapped to his back. When Tsunade asked him about it, Naruto decided to come up with a lie because he didn't want to tell his mother that about Killer B and his encounter. He told her that while he was training, a merchant with a cart was traveling on the hill and he fell down and everything was crashing, but he saved the man, and to repay him for saving his life, the man gave him one of the sword. Tsunade believed it because she thought that Naruto had no reason to lie about this, and Naruto was happy that she believed it. Naruto and Jiraiya was now near to Konoha as they could see the gateway. Once Jiraiya saw it, he stopped and turned to Naruto. "Okay, brat, this is where we part for now," Jiraiya said. "What do you mean? Aren't you coming inside with me and explain everything to Jiji?" As Naruto called Sarutobi Jiji. "Sorry, brat, but I have somewhere I need to go first. And once I'm done, I will come back," Jiraiya said. As Naruto raised an eyebrow, he didn't believe Jiraiya. "Does this thing you have to do first involve you going to some hot spring and looking at naked girls?" Naruto asked. "Because if it is, I will tell mom that you leave me and went out peeping. And I will also get payback," said Naruto with an evil smirk as he cracked his knuckles. Jiraiya was freaking out as Naruto got that look that Tsunade had when Tsunade usually beat him down. Hey, now Naruto, there is no need for you to tell anyone anything or do anything because I'm not going to peep. I'm going to deal with some real business." "I don't believe you," said Naruto. "Well, I am serious. I'm going to meet one of my contacts. He has some information for me," Jiraiya said. As Naruto then sighed, "Okay," he said, as Jiraiya smiled. "See you later, kid," as he went off, as Naruto watched him, till he disappeared out of view. Naruto then reached the main gate, where he showed them a permission slip that Sarutobi sent to him couple months ago so he could get into Konoha without any trouble. And with that, Naruto entered. As he saw the Hokage's tower, he also saw the great stone faces with his great grandfather and his father Minato. As he realized that three of the Hokages were relative to him, even his great uncle, the second Hokage, his mother teacher, as Naruto smiled, as he knew he had a lot to live up to and become strong as all of them combined. Soon enough, Naruto reached Hokage's residence and entered and went over to the stairs that led to the Hokage's office. When he got there, he saw the Hokage's secretary to the right at her desk, as she was stamping a couple of papers. "Can I help you with something, young man?" she asks. "Yes, I would like to see the Hokage, please," Naruto replied. "I am sorry, but the Hokage is a very busy man. Do you have an appointment to see him?" the secretary asks. "Well, the Hokage will be expecting me. He knows that I'm here," Naruto said, as the secretary looked at him. "Look, could you just go in and tell him that Naruto is here? If he knows who I am, I'll go in. But if he doesn't know, I'll just leave," said Naruto. The woman looked at him as she sighed. She then went inside, as she told Sarutobi that Naruto is here. The secretary was surprised to see a happy look appear on the Hokage's face as he quickly called the Anbu out of the shadow. As he told them to leave, he then told the secretary to tell the Anbu outside to leave as well, as they are dismissed. He then told her to bring Naruto in. The secretary went out and did as she was instructed. She then brought Naruto in. "Oh, it's very happy to see you, Naruto," said Sarutobi as he looked at Naruto with a proud smile. As he took in Naruto's appearance, "You have gotten big," said Sarutobi, as Naruto smiled. "You know, the last time I saw you, you were wearing diapers," as Naruto had an embarrassing look on his face, as the secretary looked at him. "You look so much like your fa-" as Hiruzen stopped himself from saying "father." "Like who, my father?" Naruto said with a smirk, shocking Hiruzen. "You know about him?" Hiruzen asked. "Yeah, I know everything," Naruto said. "How?" "I figured it out myself," Naruto told him. As Sarutobi was surprised, he didn't expect Naruto to know anything about his heritage. "What do you mean you figured it out yourself?" Sarutobi replied. "That's a long story, and I will explain it right now," said Naruto, as he sat down in front of Sarutobi's desk, as he started to explain everything and tell him how did he know about his father. As the both of them spent a couple of hours talking about everything, as Naruto told him about the Kyuubi seal inside of him, Naruto told him the people who he met on his trip, as he lived out the cloud ninjas, only the fire daimyo's daughter, and the princess who he met, who he defended from the group of missing ninjas. As the both of them talk, as Sarutobi, he was feeling happy to finally meet back Naruto and hearing about his wonderful journey. When they stopped talking, Sarutobi got over to his desk and took out keys and handed to Naruto. "It is the apartment you will be staying in," because he couldn't go to his father home yet, because it will draw too much attention to himself, and the Senju part of the village was destroyed because of the Kyuubi attack, so Naruto will have to stay at this apartment. Naruto understand as he nodded his head. "Now Naruto, the class graduation will start tomorrow at 9, and I already explained to the teacher Iruka, so he should know everything. Well, all he really knows that you're a new student who is going to take the exam and that you were trained elsewhere. He don't really know anything about you that much, so don't go and leak anything," Sarutobi tell Naruto. As Naruto nodded, "Also, you should know that tomorrow morning I will reveal your existence and your arrival to the council tomorrow morning, and then to the rest of Konoha later on in the evening. Since as soon as the students know who you are, they will tell their parents, who will tell everyone else. But your father's heritage must keep secret, since if they know everything, it will cause a lot of trouble for you. But there are still many who will try and use you for their own means when they hear that you are Tsunade's son and the next heir of the Senju clan." Naruto just nodded. "I understand, Gigi. Jiraiya and mom told me everything about this. They explained it all." As Sarutobi nodded, as he saw that Naruto got wise. Several hours later, for the past few hours, Naruto spent his time walking around the village. As he saw the Konoha Hospital, the Konoha Hot Spring, Konoha Library, the Academy, and the different training grounds, he was getting used to everything. after Naruto decided to go get something to eat, he heard some argument around the corner. "Come on, why won't you go out with me? Plenty of other girls will love the chance to go out with me," said a young man's voice. "Then why don't you go and ask one of them, since I have already told you about a dozen times. I am not interested in going out on a date with you, so leave me alone," the girl said. Naruto peeped around the corner to see what was going on, as he saw three tall medium boys who were blocking a medium tall brown-haired girl who was carrying a brown paper bag as it was full of groceries in her arm. The boy in the middle, clearly the leader of the group, grabbed the girl's arm as the bag dropped on the ground as everything spilled out. "Now listen to me, you will do what I say and you will like it, because if you don't, I can get my father to make things very difficult for you and your old man and that rundown stand of yours," said the boy in the middle. "Let me go," the girl cried out as she tried to loosen the boy's grip, but he was too strong for her. Naruto got pissed as he had enough. He hated bullies. "Hey," she said, "let her go," Naruto said, as the leader of the group turned and looked at Naruto. "What the hell are you doing here, brat? Get out of here before I hurt you and make you go cry to your mommy," as Naruto looked at him with no fears in his eyes. "I said, let her go. You got a big mouth, kid. And if you know what is good for you, you will leave here and shut your mouth," as Naruto glared at the boy. "Sorry, I can't do that. I won't let you hurt or threaten this little girl to be with you. Can't you see that she doesn't like you?" as the boy looked at Naruto. "So what are you going to do about it?" Naruto then pulled off his sword off of his back, as it was still in the hilt, as the boy started to laugh. "What, are you going to fight me? Let go of the girl, and you and your boyfriends won't have to limp your way to the hospital," said Naruto. The leader sneered at Naruto's threat as he rushed up to Naruto and grabbed him by the collar. "Big mistake," Naruto said. "But guys, I'm gonna be ending this episode right here. If you want to see the next part of this, you already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification. And remember to share this to all of your friends on your social media platform. And go ahead and check out my second channel. And I am going to be posting what if Naruto was trained to be a mercenary after this. So stay in tune and do not leave the channel. And enjoy all the what ifs that are coming your way. But for now, guys, I'm out. See ya. Peace.